So in this video today, I'm going to be showcasing the best settings for Keys2XInput V2, as well as explain the new advanced features of the software. Now guys, I know that all of you were expecting the video on what the pros use for this software. However, I am not able to do that video just yet, as I myself am still waiting for the pros to switch over from using the V1 software to using the all new V2 software. Many of them don't even know that there's been a huge update with a ton of things you can do that are completely new. So once we do learn how good this new software is and they all decide to update it, that's when I'll make a video covering what settings they choose to use, guys. But until then, let me show you what this new software does, like everything, and then after that I'll showcase what the best settings are in my opinion. Alright, so once you do first open Keys2XInput V2, you'll notice the all new layout with the three main sliders. These three sliders control the direction of your movement, so diagonal up is for when you're moving forwards and holding down either A or D. Strafes is for when you're moving left or right, so when you hold down either A or D only. And then diagonal down is for when you're moving backwards, so when you hold an S with A and D. These are just the basic features. What we'll do now though is we'll now move over to the advanced features, as many of you guys will know what they do anyway. So let's go ahead and do that right now. To get there, click on options and then click on the usage type drop down menu and select Fortnite Advanced. After doing that, you will notice that we've unlocked a new set of features, like the buttons option at the top right there. What these do, guys, is they allow you to access buttons you normally would have on a controller, such as a D-pad, for example. If you do want to use these to your advantage, I recommend just clicking the enable them at the bottom, and that will obviously allow you guys to use them. However, I myself in this video, I'm not going to use them. Alongside those extra features, though, you'll notice a new slider option called speed right here. This is the fourth one. What this does, guys, is it controls how far you can essentially press the joystick. So for this, I always recommend having it on the highest strength, and that is 100%. I usually wouldn't change this unless it's for the modifier key, which I'll talk about in just a little sec. And before that though, guys, you'll also notice this gate type right here, which gives you an option of using either square or circle. This basically is the shroud of the joystick on a controller, and for this I recommend using the common circle one, as I myself haven't really seen too many controllers out there that use the square one, and I don't know what sort of advantage that would give you, so I would just recommend going with the most common one, the circle shroud feature. If any of you guys out there recommend using the square one, please let me know in the comment section below and tell me why. I would love to know, because I'm just going to go with the most common shroud, which is the circle one. Next to the gate type though, you'll see this binds tab right here. In here there's obviously your binds, which I told you guys how to set up in this video on screen here. I'll leave a link in the description below, but under that binds tab right there, you'll notice that there's an SOCD option, which this option is for when you guys hold A and D down at the same time, and as you guys will know, with a joystick movement, that's just not possible at all. However, with a keyboard simulating joystick movement, when that does happen, this SOCD option will allow you guys to choose either neutral or SIP or SIP. Neutral makes it so when you press both these keys together, that's A and D, your movement will stay central. And then SIP, what this does is it actually prioritizes the last input that you press. So say if you press A and then D together, D is the last one that you press, so that will get prioritized, so you will move right instead of staying central like you would on neutral. For me, I prefer neutral. You guys may as well, or you might like SIP more. However, what I do recommend trying, guys, is both of them out to see which fits you best when you are actually playing in game with the software. And moving on to the last option, guys, this is the directional modifier, the one that I talked about earlier. What this is it's basically a optional keybind that when you do press whatever you set this keybind up to be, this modifier will activate an entirely new set of directions for that one specific keybind when you obviously do press it, which is really nice for those out there that do require different movement when you do hold down a specific keybind. It's really handy having like one obviously like overall movement and then a different one when you press a certain keybind, as you can do some pretty crafty stuff with it, which we will probably see the pros do down the line at some point. However, I myself haven't sort of ventured down that path just yet, guys, but again, when the pros sort of have a mess around with the modifier key and the rest of the settings, I'll be sure to share what they're using very, very soon when they obviously do switch over to the software. Moving on though, I want to now show the best settings for Keys2XInput in my opinion, and guys, for this I recommend using the following ones. I really like using 60 on the diag up, I like 90 on the strafes, and I like 120 on the diag down. This, in my opinion, feels super, super smooth and the most natural one for me and how I press the movement keys, obviously. However, guys, if you are wanting a more aggressive double movement to the left and to the right, you could use a one that's slightly more aggressive, and this is the following. It's 72 on the diag up, 90 on the strafes, and 135 on the diag down. And overall, if you do just want to have a play around, the parameters I recommend sticking to is between 60 to 72 on the up, and that's a diagonal up. Anywhere from 70 to 90 on the strafes works really well as well. I wouldn't really venture too far off those. And then for the final one, that is the diag down, I recommend using anywhere between 110 and 135. I wouldn't recommend going off those two much. I would just stick between them. And also for the speed, I recommend just having that on 100% or 100 all the time. And yeah, guys, that is all the new advanced features of Keys2XInput V2, and also, in my opinion, the best current settings until we do get the pro settings very, very soon when they do switch over. Guys, once they do switch over, I'll be sure to make another video on what they use, so keep an eye out for that. And that's all I've got for this video today. Leave a like if you enjoyed or if it helped out. I'll catch you all in the next one. Peace.